Good morning, YouTube. It is me, Shani. I know I've been away for a while. Just been going through a couple of things, not anything bad. It's just growth. And you know, when you go through growth, sometimes it's hard. It's very difficult. You know, right now it's 6:38 in the morning, Central Standard Time, and I couldn't sleep. You know, I was working on a project. Actually, I was working on a couple of projects, but I saw a couple of videos on YouTube, and I've been talking to a couple of friends, and my best friend, my cousin, about some things, you know, and Yahweh willing, in a couple of months, I will be 39 years old. Yes, 39 years old. And I started thinking, you know, 39, knocking on 40, and I look at the women that are in my family, not just the immediate family, but a lot of them who are outside, who don't live here with us, but second and third cousins, and the things that they've gone through, and seeing them still single. You know, I saw this video about a young lady talking about how long you're single and how picky you become, which is true, you do. However, excuse me, there comes a point in life where, you know, at a certain age, you begin to give up, you know, as far as dating and so forth. And a lot of times it is, you know, dealing with us, our own selves, internally, emotionally. And I will be talking about one of those videos soon. However, excuse me. Dealing with one of the groups that I'm in on Facebook, you know, it's a lot of men who have baby mamas. So, you know, they're of course already angry at the situation and what's going on, I can imagine. But hearing some of their conversations and talking on the phone with a couple of them, saying how women are, you know, like, due to their situations, they kind of have an outlook on life that women, after a certain age, you know, aren't honest with things. Okay, true, we've all been out there and we've all had sex outside of marriage. I'm sure that's how they ended up with baby mamas. But there's some women out there who did romp around in the field. Now, I'm one of them. And some women who are afraid to admit that they've done that, and I'm beginning to see why, because we are defined by that through other people. And even if they don't tell you, like, oh, you know, you were a hoe, their actions tell you, you know, that they'll say things like, you're tainted, you have excess baggage, you know, you aren't worth talking to, or you're not worth being with because of your past. And of course that's wrong to justify a reason why you don't want to talk to someone. For myself, it hurts. It really does hurt to see that, you know, no longer you're the 20-year-old female who could catch him. No longer are you the 25, 26-year-old, 27-year-old female who's graduated. No longer are you the 33-year-old who purchased your first house. No longer are you in that category at the age of 36, meeting men who do not have children. Maybe you have children yourself. No longer are you considered to be the first choice. No longer are you considered to be pretty, because, you know, things on your body start drooping. You start getting gray hairs, places you never even thought of. the conversations are different. And the older you get, the guys that are around you, they're either fading off, they've died, they're in prison, or they're already settled down, or they've been divorced, and they don't want to get married. They want to relive their youthful days. And it amazes me that people have forgotten the whole idea of marriage. People have forgotten the whole idea of what love is and unity is. And, you know, no longer are couples of the days of old, like my grandmother's generation, where they stayed together and married for 50, 60 years. And being close to a cougar, it's difficult. It really is difficult. And I wanted to say to the ladies that are out there who are 38, 39, 40, and older, it is hard. I'm not going to lie to you. For me, it's hard. You know, hearing the stories sometimes, it's hard. Hearing stories from other females who are the same age, who are single. And, you know, the only thing that you can tell them is, I understand. You know, there's nights like tonight where I really didn't have anybody to talk to. You know, and it's hard. And I know you hear people say, pray. And I know you hear people say, get into the word. And I know you hear all of that, all of those typical things that are told during these moments. But it's still hard. It's still hard. You know, I could be in the word. I could study. But still, there's always something. I'm just going to be real. There's always something that just creeps up in my mind like, dang, dude, you're still single. Dang, you don't have any kids. And then you start dwelling on, am I ever going to be married? Then you start dwelling on, am I always going to be in this bed alone? Who am I going to have to talk to? Because my homegirls aren't always around. And we all know what we are to do. We are to get in the word, and we are to pray. But it's difficult. And I'm not going to be the person to sit there and tell you it's the easiest journey in the world. Because right now, as you can see, tears falling. This is the hardest journey ever. And it's probably because of the things that I've done in my past. You know. It's probably because of being so promiscuous. And again, I will be talking about those eventually in future videos. But when you're constantly reminded by society, by men who are supposed to be there to support, but instead they tear you down because of the things that they've gone through. Excuse me. The things that they've gone through in their relationships. It's like you feel you're alone. You feel like nobody gets it. So, those blockers do begin to build. Those things in life do shut you down. And I understand with my mom and my couple of my relatives who are in their 50s, 60s, 70s, I understand why they say that they just forget about it. But in all actuality, you can't forget about it. I see why they do, and I see how, because of the way things happen. But I know they're alone. I really do. So, like I said, this is one of those things where you just don't know what to do. Look at how many women from the baby boomers who are by themselves. 50, 60 years old. And what ends up happening to them is they're out there having sex at a certain age, and they're getting STDs. STDs is the highest rate with women over 45 and older, especially HIV, because, you know, they feel like at a certain age, you know, what the heck, you know, I don't think I could get it, I've lived this long, I'm good, and they start messing around, or they'll mess around with younger guys, like I said, the cougar, been there, done that, that's not worth it. I'll be talking about that as well. But I just want all of you to know that who are 35 and older, it's hard. I can't sit here and tell you that this is the best thing in the world. I can't sit here and tell you that, you know, if you pick up the Bible and you just pray and pray and pray that it'll just all go away. Ultimately, they're tests. Ultimately, it's how you handle that situation at that moment. Right now, I'm a hot mess. Because, like I said, I can sleep right now at, what, 6:50. And I haven't been able to sleep yet because this is difficult. You know, pray for me. I will pray for you. Be looking for some more videos coming up on YouTube. I just wanted you guys to know that, hey, I'm real. And I might sound like I'm got it together, but honey, I don't. I really don't have it together at all. Because I struggle just like everybody else. And we gonna get through it. We really are. If you guys have any questions, you know my email. It's maylodi@yahoo.com. You can reach me on Facebook at Shani Fenderson, the author. Excuse me. And again, if you have any questions or if you just want somebody to talk to or somebody to listen to say, hey, I know what this is like, I'm here to listen. And yeah. You can tell I'm still in my PJs. No makeup, just a little gloss. You have to do a little something. But anyway, you guys, love you lots. Look forward to talking to you real soon. Yahweh will.